episode of the knife review, and today we have something very special because you can see here on the box we have a full custom made knife from Deviant Blades. So this is a custom knife maker that also has done some collaborations with Spyderco, for example the Myrtle, and there was also a friction folder that he did with Spyderco, if I'm not mistaken. So a very interesting knife brand or knife maker out of Belgium. And this is the box that it actually ships in. You have a nice Pelican case and then some foam lining here on the inside, so pretty nice overall presentation there with the box. And I got this knife off the secondary market for a quite good price, otherwise I wouldn't have picked this up. And it looks like this. It is the Deviant Blades Pelican, and this is actually a one-off custom, so it's not a regular model that he builds. It's actually one that he built off a design from a friend and customer. And the designer of this knife is called Patrick Helms, and the maker or the person behind Deviant Blades is Philippe Deleuve, and he built this knife off the design of Patrick Helms. And you can see it's a very unique design, I have to say. Very broad blade here, and the materials here are top notch. And here we have the large pocket clip, which is a bit of a signature part of Deviant Blades designs. But the materials are very nice. Here we have M390 for the blade here in a gorgeous two-tone finish. Nice hollow grind, pretty thick stock there. It's probably around 4 millimeters. Nice large Spyderco opening hole. I think that it's licensed from Spyderco since he's doing collaborations with them. Then we have a titanium frame with frame lock with no insert there. And some gorgeous Timascus inlays here, very nicely inlaid. You can see there are absolutely no seams. Very nicely done here. Then you have a floating Timascus backspacer, which is quite large there. And the pocket clip, which just shows off the Timascus absolutely beautifully. And also works quite well, but it's quite a high carry clip, and certainly you're going to get noticed if you clip something like that to your pocket there. But let's take a look at the specs here. And we have an overall length here on the Deviant Blades Pelican of 20.5 centimeters or 8 inches. That gives us a blade length of 9 centimeters or 3.54 inches. But you see you have this sharpening choil and forward finger area right here. And with that in mind, we have a cutting edge of 7.5 centimeters or only 3 inches. The handle length here is 11.5 centimeters or 4.5 inches. And that makes this knife quite large for the provided cutting edge, in my opinion. You can see here I have small to medium hands and quite a bit of space left if I go in this forward grip. If I grip back, it's also quite comfortable, but I would like to have some jimping here on this part of the blade. One nice feature of the blade is that you actually can grip into this little divot here on the blade, and that makes for a great grip for doing some cutting. And you're also actually quite safe here because this is quite a large choil before you get to the cutting edge here of the M390 blade with that gorgeous two-tone finish here. The Pelican weighs in at 156 grams or 5 3/4 ounces, so certainly not a particularly lightweight knife for its size. But of course that is because they have chosen to do a quite broad and thick blade, as well as Timascus and titanium, so that all adds up. But in hand, because of its slender form factor, it feels actually quite nice, so not overly heavy, and also in carry, but certainly not an ultra lightweight folder here. But most custom knives that I have seen are a little bit on the heavier side, with some exceptions. And another thing that is a bit of a signature styling of these Deviant Blades that you also find on the Myrtle is these large body screws. So you can see here you have very large Torx body screws here on this knife, and only on the non-show side, so pretty clean look. From the front, he even integrated the pivot so that it blends seamlessly into the overall finish there. And it's also quite a small pivot there, which I don't mind. But these large body screws are pretty much a signature of his, as you can see them on the Myrtle. And you can see that they are actually bigger than the pivot. You also see how we integrated the stop pin into the titanium handles, nicely blended there. Just a very, very nice overall design. And as I said before, the blade is M390 with a hollow grind and quite thin edge. It's quite impressive how thin he can get the edge here. You have a nice swetch at the front here. Just a great utility blade shape in my opinion. You can see how nicely the grinds are done here if you look at it head on. No markings on the blade. So if you don't have the box and if you don't know the story of this knife, you have no idea who made this knife, and that is a bit of a downside. I would like to see a Deviant Blades marking around here somewhere and maybe a mark for the designer. But since it's a one-off custom, I think the two people that are building and designing these knives are the people that know who made it, and probably also the people that intended to keep it. But this came up in a secondary market and I had to snag it up because it was a really good price there. And I just love how they executed here the Damascus inlay. Just very, very impressive stuff. No gaps whatsoever, nicely blended. Even with this smaller choil here, it's nearly completely imperceptible. There is a little bit of a burn mark or a inconsistency here in the color around this edge, which is a little bit disappointing, but other than that, very, very gorgeous Damascus inlay here, and also the backspacer is done really, really nice. You can also see that you actually have a screwed in Damascus inlay. I talked about that on my Jabberkov reviews, and that is something that I really like to see. It shows attention to detail, but a thing that I don't like that much is actually that they stick out into the handle here. I hope you can see that. So the screws are a little bit too long and stick out into the handle, and that is a bit of a downside there. Pretty easy to get to the lock bar, as you can see here. So nice and easy to close. Very easy to open with a middle finger flick, and it's quite free falling, as you can see here. Of course, the heavy weight of the blade helps there. You can also open it slowly and controlled. Flick it open with the thumb. So since it's a spider hole deployment, there are a lot of different options how we can open this knife, and I think this is a great deployment option, especially for a design like this. One thing that I really like is that he has the dark tumbled finish also on the spine of the blade. Just looks very nice, and then the hand-dropped satin, great two-tone finish there. Just a really nice feat of engineering. Here you can also see the stop pin, and when it's open, it reaches into this little notch on the blade. On the pivot point, we have some kind of Teflon washers, I think. But the action is really nice. I certainly would like to see some phosphor bronze in there, but the action is very, very nice. And there is no side to side and no up and down play. Very, very solid. The centering is a little bit here to the right, as you can see here. I can adjust that, but then the action gets a little bit too tight for my taste, so I like to have it like this. And overall, just a very, very well-made knife. I'm quite happy with the Deviant Blades Pelican here. And now let's do some size comparisons so you can get a feel for the overall size of this knife. First off, I have a knife that impressed me this year from Spyderco, and that is the Spidey Chef. You can see that here, and those two are size-wise actually nearly identical. You can see that here, so very, very similar in the overall size here. Also a little bit in the styling, you have a little bit of a Santoku style where you have the handle up in the air when you're cutting on a cutting board with the tip there. Not as pronounced as on the Spidey Chef, but still, thickness-wise, you can see that as well, that the Pelican is a little bit thicker there. And of course, this is a much more understated clip on the Spidey Chef. Next up, we have the Chris Reeve Umnumzahn. And see that here, that the Umnumzahn is a little bit longer here. Longer blade, longer handle, and certainly a more straight overall design. And then the Jabberkov Toucan in the special black and white edition with the Damascus clip and backspacer, as well as thumb stud. And the Damascus blade, Sledinox Damascus here. And you can see size-wise, those two are actually also quite close. So it's not as large as you may think it is on pictures. It actually is quite carryable. If you take a look at the value here of a full custom handmade piece, of course, You have to keep in mind that this is certainly over the top for most people, for sure, especially with these materials, with Damascus and everything, and the very intricate construction on the clip, which is actually also blind screwed from the inside, and the nice inlay work. So certainly a expensive piece here, and you're talking about the high hundreds of euros here for a piece like this. And certainly for a full handmade knife, I think I got a good deal on it, and I'm quite happy with it. But for the average user, certainly too expensive for an EDC knife. So I want to give you another close-up shot of the knife when it's open, because there's absolutely no coverage of this brand that I have seen so far on YouTube. And this is certainly a brand that can put out some very nice quality knives. As you can see here, nice chamfering all around, great lockup there, floating backspacer. So he really knows all the tricks in the books for a custom maker. Nice bead blasted titanium cut out on the outside, but nicely chamfered Damascus clip here with blind screwed attachment, large body screws, Damascus backspacer. Just very, very nicely done here by Deviant Blades. And this was my review of the Deviant Blades Pelican one-off handmade custom. And if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments, and I will answer you there as soon as possible. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.